All right, was that good? All right. Sister Hill said she had something she wants to share. You can come on, Doug. We got plenty of time. Today we were running an hour, what, here?
I've been instructed that whoever comes up here should stand in the light. So I'm just not standing in the light so you can see me. But we were told that you need to do this. My testimony is, I heard Brother Al talk about his testimony regarding blessings on his job, Brother Wayne on the job. Mine is like a personal blessing. Some time ago, I had to have some work done on my car. I had taken it in for routine kind of maintenance. And I say this not because of a car, but I'm talking about you'll see the blessings of the Lord. I'm going to start with, before I took it in, our pastor or someone, Brother Williams, had made an appeal for the Growth Project. And I had given $500, and I wanted to make it $1,000. And I said, okay, Lord, I know, but I had taken the car in before. I know what they told me I needed to, how much money I needed to have for this. But you always told me that if you would take care of my business, I would take care of yours. So I, without a question or a thought, gave the other $500 to make it $1,000. Now, they had told me at the Mercedes-Benz place that my repairs would be near $3,000. Did I have it? Yes, I had it. But I didn't want to put it on the car. You know, I didn't want to put that kind of money on the car. It was like, uh-uh. So I asked Brother Williams, where did he take his? And he gave me, suggested a place where he took his. And I called them. Theirs was about $200 under the Mercedes place. Still too much. So one morning, I do my prayer and meditations early in the morning. One morning when I was doing my prayer and meditations, I happened to have my appointment book right on my nightstand. And for some reason, after I had prayed, read, and meditated, I don't know why, I reached for the appointment book. And I opened it, and when I opened the appointment book, it fell right on the page where they told me all these things I needed to have done on my car. And I said, well, Lord, you said, you promised me that if I would take care of your business first, you'd take care of mine. And I took care, I did what you instructed me to do. So I went down, I was to take my car in that morning, and I was going to take it to the place where it was less expensive. I said, honey, would you call them and tell them I'll be in here? And he says, well, wait a minute. Let me call Sean first. And he calls Sean. Some of you may know him. He calls Sean, and Sean said, bring it in. Well, to abbreviate this story, Sean did everything I needed to have done on the car and more. And I only paid $1,200. Huh? Now, I only paid $1,200, not $3,000, only $1,200. I got everything taken care of and more. But you see, what I want to say to you is that God is in our, when we put Him first, and as Brother Wayne said, and we give as He has instructed us to give, and as He lays upon our hearts to give, when we take care of His business, don't you know He will take care of ours? Yes. Now, that was $1,800 I saved there. And how much did I give? $1,000. So that was like a net $800 there. It's like, okay, got even more here. He will do exceedingly, abundantly, above all that we can think or ask. Amen. So He is concerned about our daily affairs. You know, I always say, we come to Bible study, we come to prayer, to learn the Word of God. But when we encounter those situations, use what we know. And if we have committed our lives unto him and we have been obedient to him, don't we have a right to ask him to do it for us? Amen. 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 So I just wanted to share that how just giving unto the Lord and how he just blessed, and even being able to get all that done, still had money left over. Amen. God bless you. Praise God.